talk about, I mean, how did you encounter the artwork of Mr. Gabby Barrett? Was it the actual work that you produced? And what was your input from the aspect? And how did that change your work?
All this. Well, you know, I think you just like, you know, when the project was initiated, it was to work with Gabriel Barreto, so about his work. So I think his work is a little shock when you see it the first time. So you get an emotion. And like Paul say, you know, a lot of the work of Gabi is on the body. And as he say, the opera is like the operation and everything. And so it was a lot of emotion, and I tried to connect with what I felt looking at his work and what I could, you know, take and bring it to the field that I know, which is dance, and how to twist the dancer and the muscles and the physicality and the body in the same way or in another way that Gabi is doing. So that was the main, you know, starting point, is how humanly and how physically the dancer can be, like, you know, operate, you know, lively without any blood and bones, things. But they are bleeding a lot in rehearsal. This is private.
Aside from the hemorrhage, what are the other challenges that you are?
Everything is challenging for me. No, I think it's a challenge. You know, when you work as naked as they are, you see them, they have nothing to help. No protection, it's not a American football, it's not, you know, they have no costume. It's really pure muscle physicality. So in that thing, but also you can feel that they have a range of emotion. Amazing, the body can talk without the words, and he says so much more than what he can say. As Gabi work, when you look one piece of his work, well, everybody has a different perception, a different emotion, a different sensuality, you know, by the, and I thought the dancers have the body like the athlete is athletic. Well, so when you see a runner, when you see Usain Bolt running, you see the muscle, you see the effort, you see the challenge, and I think the dancer, they are in this time. This piece is very, very tiring for them, very challenging, and physically, but also they have to be full of emotion, and share an emotion, and give an emotion that is like, well, anyway, this works. Did I answer to your question?
I wanted to relate one story. For example, I think Gabi and Red are in a part where they're really collaborating and talking to each other. For example, initially we had wanted a lead character, one boy, but Red had this idea to make them twins, which also appears a lot in the work. If you notice, like the one downstairs, we have two fetuses and all of this. So they're starting to interact with each other that way, and I think it's affecting both the work. And hopefully it will be for a better show.
And I think, you know, because I think we were very scared to each other to meet, because, you know, like you meet a big artist and the other one meets the choreographer, and, you know, it's like, it's always like, you don't know if it's going to work. And I thought it was like very strange how to feel that, you feel him so much, and I guess he feels me very well, you know. And so, of course, like Paul say, he's, we're affecting each other in inspiring, you know, it's inspiring. And it's very hard and or rare this moment, because sometimes you feel like, oh no, don't touch my work and don't touch my dancer. And I think each one is like rebounding on each other, and it's very exciting for us.
He was saying yesterday, Gabi, that this is not just my work. I mean, but of course we want to please him. We want to come up with a work that is equal or that reflects his work. But he's very much interested that the company is shown well and read his choreography and the dancers.
Are the intention? I'm sorry.
Yes.
Senior one, sorry.
Are the intentions of the... or the maker of the artist of the production clear, or are we or can we interpret interpret it in a wrongly or hopefully correctly, or
I think like most contemporary art, it's open to many interpretations and it's very layered work. I failed to mention, for example, that we also have some videos that Lyle Sakris and Fabrica is doing. So that's also part of the installation. And while there is some sort of storyline that we have provided, I think that's more of inspiration because you can really interpret each part. And I think Red is also doing like a very massive canvas that maybe when we see it from a distance, but of course you'll focus on different things. So maybe that will lead to a different interpretation of the work. But I guess ultimately the idea of liberation from the body is the goal. And to achieve that through a lot of violence, the process of life, medical problems and all of that. But ultimately the liberation of the body.
Yes, Paul. Who created the storyline for this piece? Because it touches both mortality and immortality.
Yes.
So was that the original concept or it just came about in the creation?
In terms of creating the ballet, so very unusual because we have the artwork, but we're very lucky to work with people who work very closely with Gabby, like Erwin. Erwin has been working with him in his past few exhibitions as well. Erwin is a great producer of music as well, so he's actually some sort of creative consultant for this. So that was probably the first layer, but also there's a collaboration with the choreographer himself. So like the idea of the twins is a new thing that Red was inspired by from the artwork and also the dancers themselves. It was in choosing the characters that he said, maybe I'll give the opportunity for these two guys. So in that way, some sort of dialogue. Also with Gabby, yes.
A question for the dancers. What was your first impression when you saw the marriage or fusion of the two arts? What came to your mind? And second question is when you are actually expressing it, how goes in your head? I'm just curious.
When I saw the work, I realized that it's really based on the human anatomy and how the muscles and of the bodies are working. So in our, like for me, when I dance, it's like, that's one of the things that I consider when I do a step. Like I really go through all the muscle control, or I just use my muscles basically. Since I'm the mother, I also checked out the two fetuses that was there in the exhibition. So para lang ma-relate ko lang yung being a mom, I guess. Kasi wala ako nun. Hindi ako nanay. So yun.
Anybody?
Knowing Red is gonna choreograph this ballet and then of course Gabby and his work. The first thing that came out to my mind was this is gonna be tough because these are brilliant creators. And then coming from a Christmas vacation when you have those fads, it's gonna be tough to, like Reda said, that's why one of the reasons why he wanted no aircon in the rehearsal is for us to sweat. Because we understand that Gabby's work is so physical. And then we have dancers also has to show their physicality and their dance. But the emotions comes first, and then from that emotion, translate it into your physicality. And then that's Reda's work. And then from the work of Gabby, just fused into, I don't know what's going to happen in 3 more weeks.
I wanted to point out also that Reda chose to work with just about 17 dancers. Mm-hmm. Usually, in the company, we have about 40 dancers. So that every one of them is... Pinag-isipan niya talaga nakasali sila, and they have a special part, and it's part of his conception. So for the dancers, that's very special. Yeah.
Okay, I may jump in. I wanted to ask about the interaction with the artwork, because we saw some pieces in the exhibition, in the set, that will actually be used in ballet. There's one particular, the rib cage.
Mm-hmm.
As the work evolves, will are you and Gabby thinking about like what kinds of piece, how the work, how the movement and the work will start interacting with each other? Have you had conversations about that process?
We always talk, you know, we always talk, and I think, you know, it's like, you know, Gabby works and I go and say, oh, can I do this? Can I enter in the cage? And can we do this? And he said, of course, do everything you want. Because I think he has this incredible open mind and also love of dance, you know. Mm-hmm. So this is, I think, his big thing, because you can see even in his work, his movement is not flat. There is a movement. Is a rib cage, or is material that are torn, or is an open heart. So it's not something that is very politically correct, you know, in an art. So I think he takes risk. So of course, when you see this, you want to be part of that. You want that the dancer come out from his work. So we try, and sometimes we have idea and they work, sometimes it don't work, you know, but this is life. I think it's to create the process that when we meet, that he is full of idea, and we share and we stare, and after we say, okay, can I take your statue? Can I take the mask? And he say, okay. So it's, I think it's an exchange process, not a very fixed and stable, like, okay, the ballet is this and the expo is this. So during the process of creation, he is changing, and I think it will still evolve. You know.
It's the same, just to also share that it's also the same with the music. So Malik Lopez is actually based in Singapore right now, so he does a lot of Skype conversations with Reda. Also, sometimes with our resident music director, Jed Balsamo. So the music is still being put together.
Yes.
But that's like what really makes it an opus, the whole work. It's all new music, the exhibition, and the dance.
Yes.